My name is Anne Brand, and I am a mindfulness teacher who works with the A.I.M project as a mindfulness specialist at UW-Stout. You hear the word mindfulness a lot, and it's like on the cover of Time magazine, and it's, but what actually is mindfulness? So mindfulness can be defined as a particular way of paying attention to our present moment experience as it arises right now without judging it, without being harsh on ourselves. So noticing all parts of our experience, what we're thinking, what we're feeling in our body, our emotions, and all the different sensory information that's coming in around us. Mindfulness practice is a way that we can support well-being for educators. As teachers are the heart of education, it's really important to find ways to support the educator so that he or she can bring all of their gifts and talents and knowledge to the table in order to support students in learning, development, and to help build community in their classrooms. Teaching is a relational profession. Students learn through relationship with their teacher and the teacher being tuned into the student needs so that they can respond in the most effective way to support that student. A mindful educator can shift the climate in the classroom without even teaching mindfulness to their students. Mindfulness is a human capacity. We all as human beings have the capacity to be present, to pay attention to our experience, and to cultivate self-awareness and self-understanding. Mindfulness is a kind of mental training. So just as we tend to our bodies to make our bodies stronger and healthier, we can tend to our brains and cultivate this capacity to pay attention to our present moment experience. But it takes practice. You know, it's something that is a practice. So mindfulness is this capacity to be present, but mindfulness is also a practice where we practice paying attention to our present moment experience in this way. And as we practice it, we grow our capacity to show up for our lives. And we notice when we're not paying attention. And then when we notice what we're paying attention to or what we're not paying attention to, we can choose what we pay attention to. We can choose things that bring us joy.